Alright, one for Dave of Dea Thraho. That is the view south, down Malhamdale. Bloody great hill. Malhamdale, it becomes the River Aire, going down that way. Out in Airedale, way to the southeast. In the general direction of Skipton and York. York, Leeds. It goes to Leeds, not York. That being south, and me having been out all day, the sun has just set to the right, which is west. You can see over there, that altitude contrail is very brightly lit. And the sky over there is much brighter than the sky over there to the east, where the sunset was several minutes earlier than it was here. Looking to the east, you can see high altitude clouds that are sunlit, and low altitude clouds that are not sunlit. Looking here, you can see ground that is not sunlit. If you want to look at earlier videos from today, you will see how little of the tops of the west-facing slopes on the eastern sides of the valleys was sunlit, and that was a while ago. So sun has set over there, that part of the sky is still sunlit, high altitude contrails over there are still sunlit, but the sun is no longer lighting the ground here. Look over there, see that thing? That's a sunlit high altitude cloud. Might be a contrail. More up there, more up there, more over there. That one that is now out of focus but still visible as a bright pink blur because it is lit by the light of the setting sun. The sun is only just setting at high altitude where that cloud is, a long way east of me. West of me, at low altitude, the sun has already set, which means the sun is visible a lot later in the evening from higher up than it is from low down. Flat Earth debunked, Earth curvature demonstrated. There's your proof. You owe me 3 Bitcoin.